So I came here to give you all a hands-on experience about Robert framework. Actually, it's a kind of keyword-driven framework. It is easy for any person who starts automation to continue on automation. For some people, they would like heavy coding. So this is a framework which has a lot of libraries, which will help you to kind of automate most of the platforms which we have now, mobile, web, and even desktop applications. So let's start on it. Okay. So in here, basically, I will cover what, some of the libraries with some hands-on experience. So I will be doing it on Robot Framework IDE because I don't want to make it complex. I just want you guys to learn something when you go out from this room. Okay. So this is one of my, to make you all interested, this is one of the drawings that my daughter wrote me. And my wife and daughter, they are accompanying me in this conference. So thanks to my wife, I am here. Actually, we had a problem in the aircraft also. So finally, we made it. So we missed one flight, but finally, we got a flight and we came here. We had a disastrous situation, so it's okay. So let's start. Robot framework was introduced in 24th of June, because the Nokia networks, they came up with this framework. So they commercially released it, and it's very much, it is open source, right? And it's keyword driven, done in Python language, okay? It is developed on Python, and we can run under Jython and Python. So Jython is used, we can, in robot framework, we are not restricted to the libraries that they have they have in their website. Okay, this there are internal libraries and external libraries. Some are supported with the robot framework itself, but there are third-party libraries like Selenium library. You have to get it installed. Okay, so we can run, we can make our own libraries using Java, Jython, or we can make .NET libraries using IPython. So it supports multiple platforms, right? So Windows. Okay, now what I'm going to demonstrate is in Windows environment. But in my company, I have done a project to be client. It's a huge client. So it's it is run on Linux environment, CentOS. So then it can be run on OS X. Okay, that is Mac. So you can write on, you can do it on write, which is simple. Okay, and also you can do it in a simple CSV HTML. Tab separated files, so you can just get the Notepad++, and you can write your own code, and you can run it through command line. Okay. So this is the architecture of Robot Framework. Actually, you have this data separated, then you have the execution engine developing Robot Framework itself. Okay. Then then we have test libraries, which gives the capability to Robot Framework to execute under different environments. So this test libraries is a crucial part, which expands the capability of automation with Robot Framework. So these are the libraries that I'm going to cover. Some of the libraries I can't cover all during this 1 hour session. So I'm going to try my best to cover some most of the libraries, and I'm going to give you a hands-on tutorial experience. Okay, the main important thing is, now I'm going to cover, I'm just going to glance through this. So we have, at the beginning we have to tell which libraries that we are going to use. In this is the main components in a robot framework script. So we have settings, which we can specify the libraries, and we can create custom libraries also in Robot Framework. Okay. So the test cases, we can use keywords supplied in the library itself, or we can use these keywords and come up with our own custom keyword in Robot Framework. So if you want to say go to a browser, open up a browser, we can say open up a browser, then log input username, input password, and click login. We can make it to one simple thing, login, my login. Okay, then we can also parameterize the keyword also in Robot Framework. So you can create your own custom keywords in Robot Framework. So these are examples. So these are keywords, and we can combine more than one keywords and come up with one single keyword. We can call it in the test case. So these are, we can make our own user keywords in Robot Framework. Say we can have Selenium key, two or four Selenium keywords, and we can come up with our own keyword and we can call it in that script. So this is an example where they have created. So you can see even create user, they have created two new keywords and come up with a custom keyword, user keyword. So you can create variables in Robot Framework. So variables should accompany $, then curly brackets, and you can give the variable name. So then you can pass the variables into your test cases. So here, username variable, they have given two tab space. You have to use tab spacing in order to identify in Robot Framework key. You cannot use the normal space keybar. Okay. Then other good thing is you can like Selenium scripts. You can use test setup. That is like if you want to create certain prerequisite functionality before the test case, you can put it in setup. And if you want to fill the browser and those things, you can put it in the clear down. Okay. So we are doing a tutorial, right? So I think we have to install this shall we get it? Who has installed this? You have installed it. Any other person? First, Robot Framework works in Python. So you have to go to python.org and let's install this version 2.7.1. So anyone who is in automation background? Who are? Have you used Robot Framework? Selenium. Yeah. Selenium is a very kind of popular tool.
Yeah.
Even I have worked Robot Framework. I did a POC, but then we got a project. So we always thought it was a Selenium project. So even Virtual recruited me as a Selenium expertise guy, but unfortunately we got Robot Framework. But their whole framework, they are homegrown framework. That means they had their own coded framework. They want to continue, convert this into a Robot Framework. So shall we go to this site and get this installation download? I might have it, or it's. So, you all have internet connection? Okay. I'll download it and give. It's not there. It's not there, I think. You have pen drive? Pen drive or...
I have pen drive.
Yeah. So to install write framework IDE, after you install those three, you can do a go to command prompt and try this command, make space install our framework dash write. Then it should get installed. We have internet, we have internet connection. Operating systems like I'm going to use and also demonstrate in the previous session I'm going to demonstrate some libraries that can be with this. So operating systems library we don't have to install since it's supplied internally. Library also I'm going to demonstrate it. Auto IP also let's try to do it. In this Intel IP, try to download the Auto IP library. Which Auto IP library provides you the capability of automating Windows applications. Okay. It is same as the Auto IP, which is okay. Then HTTP library also. Okay. So. This side. This side. Yes. So we still install the PT selection. No space in here. Conversions. So you can do a lot of things to the built-in library. Then you have the string library to do string manipulations, concatenations, and you can check screenshots. We can take screenshots whenever we want with the screenshot library. So externally, we have Selenium 1 library, still they have it. Then Selenium 2, they have libraries which supports even another extended Selenium 2 library, they have it now to support AngularJS. Functionality. So Auto IT, then iOS, Android automation, they have a library. Database, to handle database queries, they have a separate library. So it's very simple, you just have to have the, you can go through the documentation there. So external library people, they have also provided documentation, so they can just go to get the keyword and they have very much detailed explanation. They know, they tell us the keyword and what parameters that we have to pass. So it's very easy.
So what are the libraries available for iOS and Android?
This is for iOS and Android. It's apart from APM. APM, there is a library called APM. I have not included here. This is a separate one for iOS and iOS automation.
So we can normally install it. installed.
Yes. 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 iOS and also for Android also there is a library separate. But most of the people use it APM.
So this can be used as a complete solution for web as well as
that. Yeah, yeah. So it's like this robot framework is keyword. So you don't have to know Java. If you want to use these libraries, you don't have to use, you don't have to worry about complex Java kind of coding. So if you use Selenium, you have to know Java and everything. But here it's just a matter of giving the keyword and the implementation of the that particular library take care of itself. So the person who wants to start automation, this is ultimately good tool. And also it is it has lot of libraries. You can, in your single test suite, you can input these multiple libraries and do a lot of functionality. But you can, if there is a Windows, if there is a Windows kind of a program plus with and plus mobile, right? That's how it is. So you can use this single tool and do everything. It's a matter of getting the libraries. And they are provided for you.
Image artisan
for
what? Image.
It is our image manipulations, changing portrait, landscape, and those things. Okay, so once you install Rive, so you can go to your command prompt and type rive.py. So it will bring up your this robot Tiny. So in QA, the automation is kind of a demanding area, obviously. And I won't say manual testing is going to go out, because it should be executed once or twice. But the demand is more towards automation engineers. Even in Sri Lanka, say, you don't know automation, you're lost. It's going to go in that trend. And the other thing is, more the tools you know, more you are defined. But the other thing is also now, IDE, Selenium IDE is it's no use. No Java code. Most of the people nowadays, I was, before Quercia, I was in another company, I interviewed 150 people. But the thing is, when we say automation, they start with IDE, but that's of no use. It is much more better than the Selenium. So in this one, you can also go to the settings. In this case, you can put your setup and TA down also. Final, okay. What's your name?
Okay.
Yeah, okay. So when I'm going to run, so you can simply create a new project, and by right clicking that, you can create test cases. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to execute this. So you select it. Now here I have set of keywords and values. So I'm going to have a test case which will register a person. So it will execute Fiber. The other one, I'm going to delete this. In the other test case, this is I'm using the English library called operating system. So you can do anything. You can create files, you can copy files, you can create directories, you can get the number of files within the directory. Or you can run an operating system functionality or calculator or exe anything. So you can use this use this library to do operating system functionalities. So what I'm going to do is, since I have limited time, I'm going to no rush. Okay, so if you guys want, I have kept a card, so you can contact me. I'm happy to help you. Okay. So what this does is, it creates a file. Creates several text files and also it launches calculator. Okay. It creates a directory, creates some files, then lists the files and runs calculator. So these are some of the functionalities which is provided in operating system. So that is there. Then I used AutoID, which is also the I have used a subset of the keywords, right? So I am opening up a calculator and I am waiting till the calculator comes, then maybe it has activated. Then I am going to do some calculator functions and get the results. Okay, I am going to automate the calculator. So you can if you have a Windows application in your company, you can basically there is a when you install AutoID, there is this spy functionality, right? AutoID spy. So then if the bracket spy, you will get the information about that particular component. From that, you can code this. Okay?
Is there a recording feature?
No. Not yet. Not like I will easily hear. But it's better you guys do some of this. Because recording makes people lazy.
I know.
Yeah, no problem. You can have one single test case and you can have several. You can, the libraries are specified here actually. You can specify the libraries. So I am using Selenium 2 and I am using operating system AutoID 65. You can have one test case calling all these libraries. You have that flexibility.
And we can launch it on other nodes and all like grid feature? On other nodes?
No. Yes, local machines and also you can use the SSH, that is connection, you can run it on remote machines also. It's SSH because the project that I handle use SSH project to connect into, if you have a remote Linux machine, you can connect into that, you can with the IP address and the password and everything, and you can connect into a remote machine. That is there.
So,
on VMs,
can be
yes.
Can I have Sigli library as other than, let's say, if I want to use other than AutoID, can I use Sigli library?
Sigli library, yes. If they are provided in this one, it's there if you can use it. Otherwise, you can import that library and create a Java file, and you can create a Java library and call it. If it's not provided. actually you have to know a little bit of program. You have to be a Java programmer to use that libraries and be able to
customize.
On
even, to a certain extent we can
customize.
No, strictly Java, there will be strictly jar files will be there.
Yes.
So can I use that jar files here?
You cannot straight away, but you can create a Java library and call that.
Java library to perform actions using the strictly jar file.
Yeah.
And those definitions can be included in the library.
Library. So you have the capability, provided you know it is Java. You can create a jar file and import it.
I think it's the same concept that the external jar files where
yes, even in Selenium. Selenium, somewhat.
Some extent.
Yes.
By writing your own library.
Yes, you can write your own libraries and integrate.
Yeah,
yes. So, this is Auto IT. So, it calculates, verifies. So, it will do the calculation. So, you can automate. From AutoIT, you can automate even in AutoScript files, AutoIT to library. You can use it in Selenium. So it is same as you using Selenium, you can port here. But this is simple, like they give the keywords and you can go with the keywords. Right? Then we can do this is the HTTP library. Okay? So you can have kind of now for this site, Hindustan Times, I'm getting a 301 error. Permanently. So what I'm going to do is if I want to expect some kind of 200 or something, I want to do some testing on whether this site is functional, whether it returns 200, 300, 1 or 400 error. So you can use a HTTP request and get the response. So you can do that also. They are returning a 301 error. So I had a site, but I don't know through this internet connection, I cannot access that site. But I tried Hindustan, so it gives me a 301 error. So I'm just...
I just want to demonstrate how HTTP library works.
So basically, you can capture the request and...
Yes, request and you can...
Can
say,
we alter it and do security testing with this?
Like a spider.
They intercept the proxy.
Can we use this tool for that also? Like changing the request parameter or something?
Yes. And you have to check whether the response, what's the response value? Same thing, you have to send this, right? You have to send the URL / subdirectories and those things, you can send it and you can do. Simple core functionality is this, you can customize.
I think you are talking about security.
Yeah.
You can't hold it for the time being.
You cannot hold it.
Can we hold the request, intercept, hold it and then?
The middleman attack,
which
will not hold for
the request. Hold the request and then send it.
Only thing is you can send the request parameters here and
accept.
If the site goes down, it can be. So then I have XML library, okay? So this is an XML library, okay? I can read XML files, I can input nodes, so I can add an element, I can save it, add a node, and what I'm going to do is I'm passing this XML, and I'm getting the attribute, I can display the attribute in my log entry. Log will actually display it in the log file. There is a reporting structure. So that reporting is very well done, developed by robot framework. I'll show you the reports. Then I'm going to get the element and I'm going to check whether it's equal to this particular text that I'm expecting. Then I'm going to add a library, add an element, and I'm going to save it. I just want you guys to go learn this simple. That's why I'm using the simple things. I can go harsh. Hardcore programming, but then you won't get anything. So I want to just highlight the capabilities of Robot Framework, how you can integrate these libraries and expand your testing.
Can we parameterize this test?
Yeah.
Different input for one test?
Yeah, you can. can use data driven also. So you can even everything, you can parameters and run.
So we can we create a suit like let's say I want to you know I'm doing a web testing let's say but there is a one case where I would be needing the help of let's say Windows Explorer where my Selenium would not work.
Okay.
Right.
So but yeah, it's in Windows.
Yeah, because it is Windows where I would be needing the help of Photo ID or let's say Simply, right? So in that case, I create a case in Auto ID and then add that the test case in the suit and run it as a complete under Open framework.
Yeah.
Is it possible?
Yeah.
Okay. How
do
we create a suit? So let's say under this all these headings, subheadings, Selenium is one test case, Auto ID is one test case. Now I want to run it
as a suit.
Yeah,
you can check box and can. And you can run it in command prompt also.
Flow में चले आया.
Yeah.
With the sequence.
Sequence.
You can call like this. Okay. Python /m then robot. Then you can run your robot too. Without checking, it will run again. As a suit.
No, but thing is, so let's say then this example which I have given. In one test suit, I would be needing the help of auto ID in second test case. But in another test suit, I would be needing the help of auto ID in fifth test case. Let's say. In that case, how would we do it? Because this is the sequence, right? Which will go one by one by one.
Yes.
So how do we?
You can the main suit file. You can import both Simply and auto ID and whatever libraries you want to include in the suit file.
Yes.
Individual test cases might use the library functions or might not use that.
Okay.
So in the suit file you have all the libraries imported.
Yeah.
And the individual test case you only using the.
Because I'm not very clear about the actually the folder structure. I mean what structure the Robo framework is following. So, because there is one test case under the heading Auto ID and there is another test case under heading STDB, right? I can add multiple test cases under those headings, right? Now my question is, I want to call a particular test case under one test suite and that same test case under another test suite but in a different sequence, using a different sequence.
So probably what is shown in the ID, there is created only one test suite.
Yes.
So if you have multiple test suits, you will get multiple test suits.
How do we do it?
Can we set the order between the suits basically? Right?
Isn't
that?
Yeah, sample
is
one test suit. Yeah, sample is one test suit. Then you can have another test suit.
So under sample, how many test cases are there? If sample is one test suit, so there are what? Seven test cases?
Yes.
Six test cases,
yes.
Right?
These are
now, if I don't check any box,
yeah.
Okay, this will run all six.
Yes.
Correct.
Yes.
And if I check, let's say two, first or fifth.
Okay.
So
this
it
one,
will run
one and the last one.
First or fifth, let's say.
Okay.
So it will run first test case for Selenium would run first and then what?
Then it will be the fifth one.
It will run the fifth one, right?
Yes.
Now. Suppose tomorrow I want to run the fifth one first and the first one second. How do we do it? Do I need to change the entire structure again?
No, you can just right click on that and move the test case.
But
right,
you have to do it again and again, that's not my question.
Or the second option is to execute it from the command prompt.
Yeah.
If you execute it from the command prompt.
You see, so again, so there are suppose 100 test cases. I cannot give a sequence in command prompt, right? Then how do we do it? So because what I see the advantage of using framework, this Robo framework is like we can expand or use any library whichever you want, which is good. But the flaw which I am finding is the test suit is not defined. My test suit may change tomorrow.
Yeah, but when we do an automation framework, right? So my practice is we have to create it independent. We cannot be dependent. So even my current project, we have to run it independent. So it doesn't matter now. We cannot create dependencies between the test cases.
Question
no,
question
of course I can use test cases. I can reuse test cases
like
under different
one test case.
Yeah, change
the output of the one test case may be required another test case as input of that.
Yeah.
Right? In that case, this question could be relevant where the sequence would be there.
I mean, this is a classic example. So suppose I want to upload some file using the Windows Explorer.
Yeah.
So
that's
what
I'm
saying. And I want to use that, reuse that test case, you know, many times in a single shoot only. Yeah, then how do we do it?
So
that is resource
files. So in that case, you can have that test case as a keyword, which is included as a part of the sentence.
Yeah, it's like resource files. So what I'm doing is...
It expands the settings part of it. It expands the setting tab.
Setting tab, and I'm using a resource file, right?
So here, in the setup portion, you can include that particular file or that particular test case, which is creating the file and uploading it in Word directly.
Yeah.
That can be made as a keyword. So that keyword can be a part of all this, of the setup file of all the test cases where you want the file to be present. And in the teardown, you can delete the file if you don't want it.
So that's what this example that I'm going to show.
So there is a difference between a test case and probably a function.
Commonly used.
A small part of a test case which will be required to work in the test case.
Which is a kind of workaround, but again, also, I mean, so nowadays the concept has been changed in, you know, like reusing the test cases is what we are discussing nowadays. So one test case which has been created, we can reuse the same test case again and again in different suits.
Yeah.
You do not need to create another test case in different suits.
Yeah,
so
that is the thing, that is the thing it's happening here.
Yeah. Instead of calling it a test suit, can you call it a small module?
Yeah.
So if it's a small module, being reused again and again. Instead of having a separate test case, just make it as
No, I am very specific. Test suit and test case, because I have been, you know, facing this issue since long time. That's why I am very specific that I want to reuse a particular test case under different suits. Or there could be a chance that I want to run a particular test case many times under one suit only.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what my question
so
is.
So for that,
right?
You just define it as a, instead of defining it as a test case, there is a separate option over here to define it as a keyword.
Yeah.
So that can be
reused many times. So this resource file.
I give you another example. I want to fill a form.
Okay.
So and one check is what, whether the form is getting filled or not.
Form is appearing.
So login, form, fill the form and log out is one test.
Yeah.
Now another test suit is like, you know, whether you can modify the filled form or not, right? Now what? I would be reusing the same test case, login, fill the form, modify the form and log out.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So I would be using that, reusing that test case.
Login part, right?
So there you can create it as a small keyword, like how I have it over here.
So you are, so you would be mapping that particular test case under, so see, that form would be having hundreds of fields, right?
Correct.
So that is one test case. So now you would be mapping into a keyword or something like that.
Correct. So probably instead of creating a test case like for a logout, you create a keyword called logout. So this logout then can be called in all the test cases. So like similarly for launching a web page, so you have a keyword that you define. You define it as a keyword.
Okay.
The functionality will be just like a test case.
Okay.
But only it is defined under the keyword option.
Okay.
Then this can be called. It's like basically a function which you are calling again and again in every test.
So same as this, right? Resource file.
Yeah.
Create a resource file. You can include your libraries and you can have that reusable component inside that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Test suit
just had a couple of questions.
Yeah.
Does robot framework or Python have a remote desktop library?
Remote desktop library? SSH you can use, right?
No, for a Windows machine, a remote desktop wherein I can identify the objects on a remote desktop rather than the coordinates.
Linux and SSH is the only way you can do remote in. Other than that, not inside the remote, you know. Logging inside.
Like how you do remote desktop from a Windows machine to a Windows machine.
Yeah.
Okay. So a simple function using remote framework or
you mean you want to automate the remote desktop inside
starting. Okay, like I have one Windows application on my machine.
Yeah.
I need another Windows application on this machine also to communicate to each other.
Yeah.
Okay, suppose like I'm using Skype for Business, so I want two Skype for Business to communicate to each other.
Mm-hmm.
So I would have one client on my machine, another client on another machine.
You want to connect to, without remote desktop, you can connect to SSH, right?
But I would not be, if I connect to SSH, I won't be able to automate the application. I can do
the UI.
Yeah, UI.
That can be connect and run the, what do I do like this?
Why can't we use your grid feature?
Which one?
Grid. Selenium grid.
Why can't we have the application inside
there?
I don't know.
No, so there must be some, I mean, this is one client, this is another client, which would be having another login, right? So why can't we use grid, Selenium grid only? We can, of course, Selenium grid is again what? Library, right? We can
yeah,
use
but
it.
then we cannot use Selenium grid.
Selenium
robot framework
supports Selenium. Yeah, of course, it would be on Selenium.
For XML libraries,
because coordinates,
using coordinates
is not a.
Different, you know, yeah. I haven't used this, but it says it's support. For my project, I have not used it. But there is a, they have created an extended Selenium library to support AngularJS. No.
We can automate
iOS. You can use APM plus iOS library.
With this?
Yeah. So it's an Android library also.
Android can be automated by
APM. Can I create my custom keyword? Can I create my custom keyword?
Yeah, you can create custom keyword. You can use the standard keywords and you can develop your own custom keyword. There's a practical say you have Selenium keyword to open browser and click on your search function and you can combine this and create your own custom page.
Two keywords and create one.
More than two. You have a set of keywords and you can create your own keyword and you use it. So you can create, in your test case, you can create your custom keyword or you can create in a separate resource file. It can be resource as name as robot. Okay? You can create your custom keyword having three or four key, common standard keywords and you can import this and you can use it in multiple tests. Yeah.
The login function, I will create a set of a login. I can then perform the another any function like slash or can any of the dashboard for any kind of key, right?
Yeah.
So it can be
so
but the next question is can I perform this login function with multiple parameters from either database or Excel file?
Yes. You can so there is a database like you can use the database like in this case right? Then you can use that standard keyword and specify the data. Last is you can use the operating system and you can be the data type of operating system like we have also Selenium 2 that is an extended library and Selenium 2 library. You can multiple of libraries, you can take one single keyword which has several dynamic keywords. If you want to use this one in other cases, you can put this in your resource part, that is also wrong. So you can put this, and get this keyword and set up keywords and reuse it in my cases. You can have like, archive library is also used for zipping and unzipping. You can do auto IDs. So you can have multiple of libraries in your test case. You can use your own custom keyword and you can include parameters also. You can pass parameters. You can specify in the keyword that you have to pass these parameters. Then you, when you create the, when you call that keyword, you can pass those parameters. That you can do. That flexibility, everything is there. It's basically one whole framework which can use all these, you know.
But the more test data will need to like very big. You can make an input of the test data.
Yeah. You can do keyword driven and data driven. So iOS is for iOS automation. Have an NPM library, you can use both for Android and iOS. Most people go for NPM now, rather than individuals. So you can with APM, it supports both iOS and Android. So if you go for this one, it's hybrid. But if you go for, there is a separate iOS library and also Android library. So if you go for Android library, you can automate only Android applications, native applications. If you go for iOS library, you can only automate iOS native. This for other Mac phones, mobile phones. But if you go for this, you can do it for hybrid. It's easy, like it's just go through the documentation and get the keywords and.
So how the community is active in terms of development for
the still the development is going through this. Because the community, they are developing these libraries are getting renewed, so recently they have included this Selenium extended library, which was not there. When I was using it, was not there. They had only Selenium 2 and Selenium 1. So still the Selenium 3 has just started, so they might have a Selenium 3 library soon. But this is a recent one.
So do they take consideration while developing further? They do consciously thinking about our framework.
Robert framework, we are releasing versions also. Plus, the community also releases. These are all released by the community. These are developed. Robert framework also develops and it is supported. There are libraries which are internally supported. That's why
the extended libraries are all Python libraries. So they are built for Python, for using as a Python function. But when you import it in the Robert framework, all the functions and all the definitions which are there can be reused in the robot.
Yeah, but my opinion is more on like, see, community is giving like what substitute they really work for, right?
Yeah.
And robot framework has adopted that free of that. So,
yeah.
That is the both way to try and
That's why there are two options. One is the internal standard libraries, which are being developed by robot framework. Then there are external libraries which you have to install using Python. Then robot framework does is just builds a API towards that particular library. So there are two things that
happen. Because in my organization, it is a. in my organization, we need a project. It's for a large client. So they insisted that's what to do with this robot frame, because they want to come up with a global kind of automation frame. So they wanted to move out from their old existing one and to conduct this. So entire thing was reported against the robot frame.
And how does reporting stuff in
this? Yeah.
In case of a failure, this will actually
look red color. So,
yeah, now
the report. So, if you go and get this, go to this location.
This is a report I'm writing about.
And there's a failure, they keep this and you can go in depth.
So one last question.
So
it is producing in HTML format, right?
Yeah.
Is it possible to convert into the JUnit or something that kind of format? I'm asking because if I have to put it in the smoke to the my content decrease, so
yeah.
I can put it in Jenkins.
Jenkins, yeah.
Yes.
So it has a plugin.
Okay,
it is a plugin.
It gives three kind of reports and we can integrate it directly.
Yeah, but follow me there. I was talking about Zephyr, right?
Zephyr, yeah.
They have provided a plugin in Jenkins and they understand page changing format and the JUnit format.
Yeah.
So if I thought if something is there which can, this report gets converted into JUnit, then probably I can connect to that location where automatically through Zapi my execution status will speak in the desk.
Zephyr,
Zephyr, there is a plugin in Jenkins. Similarly, this fellow has a plugin in Jenkins. But this is just the report. So if you can, at the bottom, they generate a report, log file, and the output file. So you can go to log file and it gives more detail. This is the report. This is the log file. It gives you detail where it failed. Yeah, since it's open source, you have to be a developer to do it, and you should know the Python. You know.
Okay.
If you have a good Python engineer, definitely. It's open source. You can get the code in and you can customize it. It's open source, but you have to have a Python because it runs under Python. I just want to give a simple idea on this community and know what the tables are proper.